So this is just my running leg. This is a combat infantry badge. This is U.S. Army. And then my Purple Heart patch from Afghanistan.
Ryan lost his leg 2 years ago in a landmine explosion while serving in Afghanistan, his first tour of duty as an infantryman in the Army.
I remember my guys yelling, IED, IED. And so I didn't really know that I was injured in the beginning. I was just kind of in shock. And so then they started screaming, "Where's Mac? Where's Mac?" And so I started kind of putting my hand up to see if they could find me. And then I ended up crawling out of the ditch, grabbing my squad leader's hand that day. And I remember picking myself up and looking at my foot and realizing that my toes weren't there anymore.
All Ryan says he could think about after his injury was getting better for his son, Caden, born just 5 months after that blast.
That was probably the biggest thing running through my head, that I wasn't going to be a dad and that it wasn't going to be the same for me. And so that hurt me.
Ryan says it was his father that gave him the strength to pull through.
One of my final surgeries that I went through, I was in excruciating pain because they just shaved my bone. And I laid in the hospital bed screaming for about half an hour. I kicked everybody out of the room besides my dad, because he's the only person that I really felt like I could be that, you know, vulnerable with. And so my dad held my hand and dealt with that with me.
Incredibly, Ryan was back up and walking in 2 months, running in three, playing sports like basketball, soccer, and volleyball. In time, an Army commander, impressed with his athleticism, told him he should try out to become a U.S. Open ball person. It is a fiercely competitive process, and Ryan had never even played tennis.
It's kind of like, a ball person? What is that? And so I went to a tryout, and at the clinic, they're like, "All right, well, can you throw a tennis ball?" And that's when I used the word, you know, I can throw a, I've thrown hand grenades, so I think I can handle a tennis ball.
Now he assists tennis stars like James Blake and Serena Williams. Off the court, Ryan, who is still in the Army, works as an adaptive sports coordinator, helping other wounded vets get active again.
I want them to realize that, you know, life's not over, and that, you know, you can still do a lot of things and overcome your injuries and, you know, move on and get through them, because that's what life's about, is, you know, getting through the hard times and getting to the better times.